Okay, yeah, no, there wouldn't be any benefit if we're separate in separate houses. At the moment, like, there is only so much that I can help with the kids.
Yep, stop being defensive.
Okay, well, yeah.
It is well.
So, why do you say there's only so much you can help? Do you have children?
No, I do not.
So, why do you believe that there's only so much that you could actually help with? You know, let me show you that from a man's perspective. Like, a man may not be in a financial position, you know, at a point in his life where he could actually provide financial assistance for a child, right, or for a son or a daughter. Right. And so a lot of women use that as a weapon against him. And so where he could actually be providing like social skills, like teaching them things from a man's perspective, since he's not providing that financial, benefit, the woman doesn't want him to deal with them. And she'll say things like, well, you know, your father's no good. He doesn't provide for you. But at the same time, there's a lot of other things that's more essential than the financial aspects that he could actually provide. And that's proven by, you know, women that rear, single children, they're much more prone to suicide, much more prone to high school dropouts, much more prone to teenage pregnancy, much more prone to drugs and alcohol. The list goes on and on. So all of these things, and the social sciences know this, that, you know, when the father's in the home, that these things are less likely to occur. So even though when he can't provide a financial benefit, he can still provide those other things that's wanting, that, you know, a child, both males and females, need. So, you know, given that right there, so now I guess I'll go back and re-ask you, why do you think you can't provide much now? Because you'll have the same skills now that you have later. Later on when you think you could provide those. So do you mean something financially or, you know, something like some sort of form of support? Or you're just extremely busy?
I just mean in forms of like support, like just spending time with kids and, you know, being there to be able to like rear them, you know, so to speak.
Right. So you're saying you don't have time for that? You don't have enough time for that right now?
Yeah, because I have to work 5 days a week. I don't have a working vehicle myself, so I have to go when, you know, our husband is able to take me there.
But all of that could be resolved. That there's, you know, I guess you guys could work through that. That could all be resolved.
Okay, so before, you know, like the current little situation, like I said, very temporary. It would be just on the weekends. So specifically between Friday and Sunday is when that, you know, dynamic takes place. So between Monday and Thursday, sometimes Monday through Friday, that's not the case. So,
right.
But yeah, we definitely practice that in, you know, in preparation for the next step.
Yeah. So let me, ask this, Jerrica. So what if you had, a baby by him and, you had to work, would you not have time for your, biological baby by him because you have to work? Because so when we come into a relationship, like if a man comes into a relationship and he marries a woman that has children, he's assuming the responsibility of those children unless both he and she volunteers that those children go and stay with their father. So he's taking on that responsibility as well. So when you come into a relationship, you're taking on the responsibility of the children that he has also. That's how it should work because, you know, you're actually becoming a part of the life of him and the children. So what if you had a baby biologically with him? Then at the work, would you not spend any time with your biological child?
Yes.
Yes, you would?
I would.
You will find some way to make it happen, right? You will find some way to make it happen. You will make it possible. Somehow, you will work on, I'm pretty certain, this is just my thought, I'm pretty certain if you had a baby by him, you will find some way to somehow make that work out.
Somebody keeps dropping.
So it's the same case scenario. And since you work, have you been actually working towards like some sort of solution with the transportation? Because when a woman works, right, her finances is actually supposed to come into the home. That's the whole point of being in a polygamous relationship, to help out as well. So what are you doing to actually try to help rectify that situation?
Well, we've discussed a plan, and that plan is currently in motion. Matter of fact, even today, went to like a auction type of house, and just getting some temporary until we make a permanent decision. And then got another vehicle that's the van that's coming out of the shop. So yeah, we're good. It's only this. Like the answers and dynamic that's going on is only just here recently. That wasn't right. Always, it wasn't always the case.
Yeah, there's always going to be emergencies, right? So we got to choose how to deal with them.
Absolutely.
You got to be able to adapt and overcome.